A very good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining us for today's virtual Design Development Workshop. I, Amanpreet Kaur, it is an opportunity to welcome you all on behalf of the Center for Legal Studies, Vidyaratan International Business School, on this virtual platform for interaction with advocate Umang Mittal on the topic on India Bar Examination, Format and Profession. Vidyaratan International Business School was established in the year 2004. GIBS is affiliated to Guru Gobind Singh International University, Delhi. Center for Legal Studies, GIBS conducts law courses of BBLLB and DLLB, approved by Bar Council of India, and managed courses by All India Council for Technical Education, Ministry of HRD, and Government of India. The institute is accredited as Category A by National Assessment and Accreditation Council, NAC, and assesses Category A plus by State Fee Regulatory Committee, and created highest grading A by Joint Inspection Committee of Government of Institute of Delhi and GGSIP University. The institute has been rated Grade A by Cabinet of itself of GGSIP University consequently for past 6 years. GIBS has also been rated number 2 twice by Times B-School Survey 2019-20. The All India Bar Examination or AIBE is an exam conducted by the Bar Council of India with an objective to examine and indicate capability to practice the profession of law in India. As per the guidelines of the Bar Council, all students graduating from the academic year 2019 onwards need to clear this examination in order to practice law in India. The exam was first conducted in the year 2011 and is now conducted twice every year. Objective of this workshop today is to make students aware about ability to practice in the profession of law and be aware about minimum standard for admission to the practice of law. In its perpetual pursuit to deliver existential learning and offer global exposure to legal fraternity, CLS GIBS is very delighted to organize this personality development workshop and to discuss on this topic. We have with us Advocate Umang Mittal. Sir has approximately 10 years of experience, including association with reputed law firms where he dealt with civil suits for recovery for various banks and financial institutions, recovery cases before the Debt Recovery Tribunal at Delhi for various banks and financial institutions, arbitration matters and proceedings. Miscellaneous works as well as relating to national company law tribunal, etc. Sir is currently dealing in matters pertaining to various statutory civic and financial institutions such as matters of Lord Delhi Municipal Corporation as an impaneled advocate, matters of Punjab National Bank as an impaneled advocate, matters referred by DLSA as an impaneled advocate, with petitions before the Honorable Delhi High Court and Honorable Supreme Court of India, and various types of civil, criminal, family matters as an independent action. So we are delighted to have you here with us and request you to take the session forward and illuminate our students with your experience.
AIBE exam. Am I audible to you?
Say yes, you are audible. You can continue with your session. Yes, sir, you are audible. You can continue with your session.
What is AIBE exam? AIBE stands for All India Bar Examination, which is a national level examination conducted by the Bar Council of India to assess whether provisionally enrolled advocates. What is provisionally enrolled advocates? The procedure for AIBE is that, first of all, we'll take a degree of law and we'll get ourselves enrolled with the State Bar Council. So the initial step is to get enrolled with the State Bar Council, after which a candidate is a provisionally enrolled advocate, but not an practicing advocate. So the purpose of AIB is to assess whether provisionally enrolled advocates or fresh law graduates have the aptitude to practice law. Then the exam is an this exam is an open book exam. Test evaluates candidates' analytical abilities along with a basic understanding of law subjects. So what is AIB is should be clear to you now. AIB is an open book examination to assess whether the provisionally enrolled advocate or fresh law graduate have aptitude to practice law, whether he is competent to enter into the field of law or not. This is the main objective of the AIB examination. Now, to add further to it, the further objective of the All India Bar Examination is to examine an advocate's capability to practice the professional of law in India, the profession of law in India. The AIB will further assess skills at a basic level and is intended to set a minimum benchmark for admission to practice of law. So again, the objective is very clear that it is to assess one's capability, how much he would go further into the litigation process or into the legal field. Now, it addresses a candidate's analytical abilities. This is again a feature of AIB examination, that it assesses a candidate's analytical abilities and understanding basic knowledge of law. So the another objective is to assess the basic knowledge of law that the candidate appearing for the examination, who is willing to start his practice in the legal field, what is the level of the basic knowledge, who are the law of the land, whether he is able to read out the provisions or not, what is the understanding with regards to the law of the land of the candidate. Now further, after passing the examination, candidate will be awarded certificate of practice. When the candidate will qualify the exam, the Bar Council of India, which is the parent organization organizing this exam, will provide a certificate of practice to the each one of the candidate who will qualify this exam. It will be given by the Bar Council of India. Now, this is a national level examination, and since it is very difficult to conduct this examination in each of the cities, therefore Bar Council of India had provisioned the conduction of this examination in 40 cities across all over India. So this exam can be given at 40 centers in short in India, in 40 cities, not in 40 centers, but in 40 cities in India. Now, since there are many languages followed in this country, so it will be very difficult for candidates across India to give examination in one language. Therefore, the Bar Council of India has also provided a facility to get this examination conducted into 11 languages, 11 national languages. So this is again a feature of All India Bar Examination, that the candidates appearing in Tamil Nadu, they are not well versed with Hindi or English, so they can give their this examination in their own local language. Now, examination pattern will be multiple choice question. As you all know, you must be aware about the competitive examination, that almost all the exams are being conducted in multiple choice questions. So this is the same pattern being followed in this exam also. And again, it is an open book examination. The notification bringing All India Bar Examination into force. See, the point is this. Earlier, we were not introduced with this examination. And when it has been introduced, when the thought came to introduce this examination, it was in 2010. Somewhere in 2009 and 10, the Bar Council of India had already received many complaints with regards to some legal practitioner. Those are being not well versed with the law, and they cannot handle the cases in the manner to be followed. in 2010, ultimately, the All India, the Bar Council of India took initiative to introduce this examination so as to assess the basic knowledge of law of the candidate and to assess his capabilities, his or her capabilities. So this is the All India Bar Examination all about. The purpose is ultimately clear to us that it is basically a retrenchment of those who are not well versed or who are not capable to handle the field, the legal field. So it has been introduced in 2010. The persons or the candidates who have already qualified to obtain their degree in law in 2009 or before that, they need not to give this exam. So first time this examination was held in 2010. Now, what is the qualifying criteria of AIB? As I have already told you, what is the purpose of AIB? That after passing or qualifying AIB, only the person or the candidate can enter into the field of law as a legal practitioner or as a practitioner advocate. Now, naturally, there should be some qualifying aspects with regard to minimum percentage or minimum marks, after which one can be considered as a qualified candidate, AIB candidate. So qualifying criteria for AIB is AIB candidate should obtain 40% marks if they belong to general category. If a candidate is from general category, then minimum marks or should be 40%, or in general category also, and for OBCs also. Now, there is another aspect with qualification. It is 35% if the candidate is belonging to scheduled caste or scheduled tribe. So we have two bars for general and OBC. The qualifying criteria is 40%. If a candidate is holding or is obtaining 40% from general and OBC, then only he will be considered as qualified candidate. Or if the candidate is from SC or ST category, then he will be considered as qualified candidate if he or she obtains minimum 35%. So now, as we have already discussed about the AIB, so what is the necessity? What was the causes for Bar Council of India to introduce this exam, All India Bar exam? Why it is mandatory? BCI, the Bar Council of India, is intended to provide awards or certificate of practice to candidate who will clear or the to the candidate who will qualify the bar exam with above aspects which I have already discussed with you, with minimum marks, obviously with minimum marks. Those who are not able to clear AIB, those who were not able or who would not able to clear AIB with minimum benchmark of marks shall remain enrolled with their respective state bar council as provisional advocate only. This also I have already discussed with you. I have already told you that the people or the candidates who has cleared the after 2010, if neither they have appeared in the examination, or if they have appeared in the examination but they fail to get minimum mark, then they will remain only as provisional advocate but not practicing advocate. They don't have authorities to appear in the court or to practice law. Appearing for the AIB exam is mandatory for all law graduates who have completed their degree 2010 onwards. However, advocates who have graduated in the year 2009, again, I am repeating this thing because majorly the law graduates or the law students have doubts with this scenario that who has to give this exam or who doesn't need to give this exam. So people may be there in your knowns to which have been appearing in 2000, which had appeared in 2009 or earlier to that. So it is to clarify, since provision, this exam has been introduced in 2010 itself, so it is but obvious the students grabbing their law degrees or completing their law course after 2010 only need to give this exam. Now, what is the eligibility criteria? This is another important aspect about All India Bar Examination. Who is eligible to appear in All India Bar Exam? Candidate holding either their 3 years degree or 5 years degree. As you all must be aware that there are two courses of law. One is after intermediate, that is the course, that is the combined course, combo course of 5 years, and one is the previous course, which is of 3 years, and the candidate must pursue it after its graduation. So it is considered somewhere or the other around as post graduation also. So the candidates who have either obtained their law degrees or who have graduated under law either in 5 years course or in 3 years course are eligible to appear in All India Bar Exam. But there is another condition before filling up the forms for All India Bar Exam. After grabbing their degrees in law, the candidate must have to be enrolled with State Bar Council, their respective State Bar Council. Supposingly, if someone is intending to practice in Delhi, in the state of Delhi, New Delhi, then he or she must have get enrolled with the Delhi State Bar Council, which is known as Delhi Bar Council. Or if someone is intending to get enrolled with the Uttar Pradesh Bar Council, then he or she must have get him or herself enrolled with UP Bar Council. This is the important aspect before appearing or before applying for the All India Bar Exam, that the candidate must be enrolled with some State Bar Council, as the State Bar Council is the parent authority to provide license, initial license to practice under law. Thereafter, the requirement comes for AIB. So there are two eligibility criteria for appearing in AIB. The candidate must have a 3 year law degree or 5 year course law degree. And secondly, the candidate must be enrolled with State Bar Council, as we need to provide the certificate issued by the State Bar Council while applying for the All India Bar Examination. Now, with respect to age limit, I would like to tell you that there is no age limit for appearing this examination. Generally, the national level exams do have some or the other age limits, upper or the lower, but All India Bar Examination do not have any age limit, neither upper age limit nor lower age limit. But the only two criteria should be fulfilled, as I have told you. So now, what is the process for All India Bar Examination? How would you apply for the All India Bar Examination? As I know that all of you are from the final year of your course, so naturally you won't be appearing this year, but this information, whatever I'm sharing with you, naturally will be beneficial for you in the next All India Bar Examination, which will be 16th All India Bar Examination. This time in 2020, we are having 15th Bar All India Bar Examination, and you will be appearing most likely in the 16th All India Bar Examination, as you are in the final year. So this all information I'm sharing with you, or I'm giving lecture to you, will be beneficial for the next year, All India Bar Examination 2021. So the purpose of the AIB, what is AIB, what was the need to introduce AIB, All India Bar Examination, is clear to you, I think. So now the process for All India Bar Examination, what is the procedure to apply for the All India Bar Examination? You all may please note down that there is a direct link to access for the All India Bar Examination, which is every letter is in alphabet is in short, allindiabarexamination.com. This is the direct link to apply for the All India Bar Examination. Now there is a step-wise procedure. First, in the first instance, I'm sharing with you the step one. What is the step one for applying the All India Bar Examination? Candidate first need to apply for All India a bar exam in online mode. See, there is a difference. The examination is in offline mode, but you have to apply in online mode through online procedure on the official website, which I have already told you. And the second option to apply is the website of Bar Council of India also. You may apply directly from the Bar Council of India website or the link I have already told you, allindiabarexamination.com. Both the websites are having links for registration of the examination and to highlight the procedure to get further, to move further with the applying procedure. So the candidate first need to apply for All India Bar exam in online mode on the official websites, as I have told you. Now these first step will be to register before filling up the form. As in day-to-day life also, we all are habitual of surfing on internet. So wherever we go first, supposingly if we serve for the shopping websites also, then also we have to in the first instance register ourselves and create a login ID password to further access the website. So same is the procedure here also. After accessing or after surfing on the official website for All India Bar Examination, the candidate must have to register himself or herself before filling up the application form. After getting registered on the website and creating login ID password, there is a link highlighted there itself to fill AIB form. When the form is complete, online form, all the details you may have to furnish there. When it will be completed, then the admit cards will be issued. That is also done through online mode. Now, the third step will be appearance in the All India Bar Examination. Thereafter, results will be checked. It is but obvious. Now, instructions for register for All India Bar Examination. After registration or after creating login ID passwords, the candidate must have to upload all the required documents, which are photograph, a passport size photograph. The size of the photograph is mentioned in the website only, and your signatures. You may have to sign on a blank paper and scan it and then upload it. And the third document will be your enrollment certificate, which will be issued by the State Bar Council, as I have already told you, that you have to first of all get enrolled with the State Bar Council, and thereafter you will be getting a certificate of enrollment, that is called enrollment certificate, from the State Bar Council. The candidate have to upload that certificate while registering for the All India Bar Examination. All these documents means the certificate should be self-attested. The document, that is the enrollment certificate, should be self-attested while uploading it. If any of the candidate uploads the enrollment certificate without having it self attested, what is the consequence? The Bar Council of India will reject that particular application just on account of not having it self attested. Now, many a times when we fill up a form through online mode, sometimes some mistakes may happen. So there is a procedure. If you have made some mistake while entering your name, while entering your address, while entering any of the detail, if you have made some mistake, then there is a provision by Bar Council of India to rectify it also. In that case, in case if you have entered any wrong information or uploaded a wrong document, you can get it rectified by mailing the correction. You have to write a mail at aibe.bci. You may please note this mailing address also. aibe.bci@gmail.com. You have to first of all mention the mistake in a mail, that what mistake you did, and after correction what it should be read as. So both the aspects you have to mention in that mail, and you have to mail it on this website which I have told you, on this mailing ID, sorry, not website but mailing ID, which I have just told you. You may please note that any rectification request received after the release of admit card, this process you have to obtain, you have to make before releasing of admit card. If in case you mail it or you make the corrections, rectifications after issuance of the or after releasing of the admit cards, that will be solely on the risk and consequences of the candidate. BCI will not be responsible for that. So there are clear-cut instructions with regard to this, that if you have made some mistakes, that should be rectified or corrected through just informed mailing address, but before the release of the admit card. And make sure the photographs, signatures, and the document, that is enrollment certificate, is properly and correctly uploaded. And you need not to post any of the hard copies of the certificates or any document to the BCI. Now, there are some guidelines for the day of the examination also, which were released by the BCI since the initiation of the All India Bar Examination, that is since 2010 onwards only. And these guidelines, although these remains the same, but BCI may change it, a slight change would be there. So I'm sharing with you these guidelines also for the day of the examination, All India Bar Examination. Candidates should follow the instructions given in the test center officials on the exam day. Some of the instructions are that the candidate should report to the examination center at least 1 hour before the exam timing. Secondly, to avoid last minute rush, candidates should check the allotted test center location. Sometimes what happens, there may be more than one or two institutes or branches of the institutes. So to find out the exact location, you should avoid the last minute rush. Then what should you, since this exam is an open book exam, so naturally there are some instructions as to what should the candidate carry with himself or herself, and what a candidate should avoid carrying with himself or herself. you may please note down these points, because these points will be very beneficial for you. As it is a open book examination, a candidate may carry these study materials along with themselves. Any study material comfortable to you, but none of the study material or no study material will be provided at the centers. A candidate himself or herself should carry the study material, and no electronic devices such as calculators, mobile phones are strictly not allowed inside the examination centers. A candidate appearing for the All India Bar Examination must carry at least two photocopies of the admit cards, at least two copies of the admit cards, and a valid photo ID proof. What do I mean with valid photo ID proof? It should not be your college ID card. It may be either PAN card, driving license, voter ID card, passport, Aadhaar card, or the ID card issued by State Bar Council. As all the candidates would be enrolled with the State Bar Council, so an ID card is issued by the State Bar Council. So that ID card will work as a photo ID proof at the examination centers. Now, one of the important aspect with respect to All India Bar Examination, that as we have a large number of subjects or topics or enactments under law, so naturally everything can't be covered in any of the examination. So the Bar Council of India has set some of the subjects to be the syllabus for All India Bar Examination. Generally, these subjects remains the same throughout all Bar India examination held till date. You may please note down the subjects. I am telling you the subjects. What are the subjects or syllabus for the Bar Council All India Bar Examination? The first subject is constitutional law. You may note down the heading syllabus, and I'm just repeating the subjects. It is constitutional law, Indian Penal Code, Criminal Procedure Code, Code of Civil Procedure, Evidence Act, Alternate Dispute Redressal, including Arbitration Act, Family Law, Public Interest Litigation, Administrative Law, Professional Ethics, and Cases of Professional Misconduct under Bar Council of India Rules. This is one subject, Professional Ethics and Cases of Professional Misconduct under Bar Council of India Rules. Now the next subject is Company Law, Environmental Law, Cyber Law, Labor and Industrial Law, Law of Tort, including Motor Vehicle Act and Consumer Protection Act. Now, here is one thing to note. Why is Motor Vehicle Act covered with Law of Tort? Though they both are taught separately and they both have different enactments. Since the law of tort is the civil wrong, all about law of tort is civil wrong. So Motor Vehicle Act is neither can't be covered under a criminal injury. It is a civil in nature. Civil in nature. So it and it speaks about the compensation aspect. There is no penal provisions in this. So these both subjects has been clubbed by the Bar Council of India. So the complete subject under the syllabus is law of tort, including Motor Vehicle Act and Consumer Protection Law. Now the next, that is the 16th subject, is law related to taxation, law of contract, specific relief, property laws, negotiable instrument act. This is count as one subject again. Law of contract, specific relief, property law, and negotiable instruments act. The next subject is land acquisition act and intellectual property laws. So these are the subjects covered as a syllabus for AIBE All India Bar Examination. Now, what is the distribution of marks amongst the subject? You may note it down again that as per the set format of Bar Council of India, All India Bar Examination, the subject wise criteria for marks distribution is that it is a 100 marks examination of 100 question, of 1 marks for each question. There is no negative marking. A candidate will get 1 mark for each correct answer. 1 mark for each correct answer, and there is no negative marking. Even if a candidate marks an answer as a wrong answer, the marks will not be deducted. Negative marking is not provisioned here by Bar Council of India. See, although the intention of Bar Council of India before introducing this exam is to assess one's capability, but not being so harsh, Bar Council of India has made the format of this examination a bit literal. The purpose is not to restrict major part of the candidates from appearing in the exam or from qualifying. This is not the purpose of Bar Council of India. Therefore, the Bar Council of India has made this examination a bit easier by introducing this in the format of open book examination, having no negative markings. So now the constitutional law will give you 10 marks question. Constitutional law will give you 10 marks question, meaning thereby out of 100 marks question paper, All India Bar Examination, 10 marks question will be from constitutional law, 8 marks questions from Indian Penal Code, 10 marks question each from Criminal Procedure Code and Code of Civil Procedure. Sorry. 8 marks questions from Evidence Act, 4 marks question from ADR, that is Alternate Dispute Redressal and Arbitration Act, 8 marks question from Family Law, 4 marks question from public interest litigation, 3 marks question from administrative law, 4 marks question from professional ethics, 2 marks from company law, 2 marks from environmental law, 2 marks from cyber law, 4 marks from labor and industrial laws, 5 marks from law of tort, including Motor Vehicle Act, 4 marks from law related to taxation, 8 marks from law of contract, specific relief, property laws, and negotiable instrument act, 2 marks from land acquisition act, and 2 marks from intellectual property laws. So this is the syllabus. Now, what is the pattern? What will be the pattern for All India Bar Examination? Or what remains the pattern of the All India Bar Examination? Candidate will be evaluated on topics such as environmental law, cyber law, public interest litigation, cyber law and industrial law. The paper, I'm again repeating this information, the paper will carry of total 100 marks each. Question will be of 1 mark and there will be no negative marking. Candidates will get 3 hours and 30 minutes time to complete the exam. The timings of the examination will be for 3 hours and 30 minutes. Each candidate will get 3 hours and 30 minutes to complete the exam. And the paper will be, as told to you earlier, will be multiple choice questions with 4 options will be given and candidate will have to choose one. It will be an offline test, as I have told you earlier, that it will be a physical appearance test, that is pen and paper based test. There is no provision for online appearing in the examination or online examination. Then OMR sheets will be given to the candidates to mark the answers. And it is mandatory for the candidates to use only ballpoint pen only for the entries or marking answers in the OMR sheets, including filling the bubbles. If more than one answer is marked against each question, then it will be considered as a wrong answer. Now, the 20 subjects which I have told you as a syllabus for All India Bar Examination, these 20 subjects are divided into 2 categories, that is category 1 and category 2. These 20 subjects are divided into 2 categories, category 1 and category 2. Category 1, how many questions will be given from category 1? Category 1 will have 7 questions, while category 1 will have 7 questions, while category 2 subjects will have 23 questions in total. Now, what are the subjects in category 1? I'm telling you the subjects which are marked under category 1. Alternate dispute resolution, Criminal Procedure Code and Limitation Act, Constitutional Law, Contract Law including specific relief and specific contracts and negotiable instruments, Criminal Law, that is Criminal Law is considered as Indian Penal Code, then Criminal Procedure, Drafting, Pleading and Convincing, Evidence, Jurisprudence, Professional Ethics and the Professional Code of Conduct for Advocates and Property Law. And now what are the subjects under Category 2? You may please note down. Under Category 2, Administrative Law, Company Law, Environmental Law, Family Law, Human Rights Law, Labor and Industrial Law, Law of Tort including Motor Vehicle Accidents and Consumer Protection, Principles of Taxation Law and Public Interest Litigation. So these are the subjects which are kept under category 2. Now the big question arises that how to prepare for the All India Bar Examination. We have already discussed about what is the All India Bar Examination, what is the exam pattern for the All India Bar Examination, and the procedure to apply or to appear for the All India Bar Examination and requirements and qualifying marks for All India Bar Examination. Now the important aspects comes as to how to prepare for All India Bar Examination. As the nature or the objective is a bit liberal before the introduction of the All India Bar Examination, so whatever you have studied up till now, you all must have covered entire syllabus in your theoretical examinations for the university. Now, how to prepare for All India Bar Examination? First of all, you all, out of these subjects, you all would have definitely read some of the major judgments which are being followed till date. What you have to do is, you have to make a compilation of all the judgments out of all the subjects and go and have a thorough reading of it. The judgments, the questions which are being asked in the All India Bar Examination will be totally from the material what you have already read. So you have to go through those judgments. Major portion you will cover from those judgments only. Now, you have many material in the market. You can get more than one book in the market for preparation of All India Bar Examination. What people do, as I want to share one thing, my personal experience with you, I have appeared in All India Bar Exam, second All India Bar Exam, that is in 2011. And what I have seen is, that time Bar Council of India also provides the study material. There was a fixed fees for the conduction of the examination, and in that fees only, the Bar Council of India used to provide study materials. Nowadays, Bar Council of India is not providing any study material released out of the, that. But we were provided in 2011. What I have seen when I was appearing in All India Bar Examination, that the candidates sitting just after me, just in front of me, he was having a bag full of books. On a lower side, he was having minimum 50 books with him. Now, I was confused in that, what he will do with that is much study material. Though it is an open book examination, but there is a rule behind it. Make a rule while appearing, you have to appear with limited study material so that to avoid confusions as to what material you have to open for each question. Supposedly there are 100 questions. So naturally 100 questions will not be from one topic only. You may have to open different books for different questions. So it is useless and it will be a wastage, grave wastage of time. You have to secure your time. To secure your time, what can you do is, you can go through the sample or mock question papers available in the market. You will easily get it in the market on law bookshops, and you will get these study materials online also on the website of allindiabarexamination.com or on the website of Bar Council of India. You will easily get the study materials there. So you have to appear with limited resources, with limited study material. You can purchase any book available in the market which would be comfortable to you, and go through to the illustrations mentioned in the study material. You mark my words, more than 50% of paper you will get from the instructions, illustrations mentioned in the study material. what is the format of that study material? The study material for All India Bar Examination, which is available in the market, is a very concise study material, not having much detailed topics. And every topic is covered with short notes and main points in that study material. And in every topic, you will get illustrations. Certain illustrations are mentioned in that study material. Just read those illustrations, set those illustrations in your mind, and you are ready for your examination. This is the main tip for preparation of All India Bar Examination. It is not like you are going through, you are opening a book in front of you. Supposedly, there is a topic, Indian Penal Code, under your syllabus. You are opening a bare act for that Indian Penal Code and going through to the provisions. Section 1, what it says, Section 34, what it says, Section 209, what it says, Section 302, what it states. See, everything is important. I'm not saying this is less important or this is more important. Everything is important. Once you are entering in the field of law, an advocate, mind my words, an advocate is considered as jack of all trades. What does it mean? An advocate is having a knowledge of almost every sector. Jack of all trades. So this is the procedure about All India Bar Examination, and I have already discussed with you the major point for preparing for the All India Bar exam. You may purchase these study materials and just take them along with you, those study materials only. At the best, you can take 2-3 BAREX with you, such as Indian Penal Code, Criminal Procedure Code, and Code of Civil Procedure. These three BAREX and a study material. So this was my knowledge about All India Bar Examination, which I have discussed with you. Now I think this would be sufficient for your knowledge.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir, for enlightening us with your words of wisdom. You have really inspired all of our students that how to prepare and what are the conditions to get the exam and how we can be successful at it in one shot. Thanks a lot. So, a few participants have raised some questions, and I am just taking this due to paucity of time and taking one or two of them. And one question is that what is the criteria after applying for the state council? How we can go further with it?
Advocates having standing of more than 10 years of experience. have to get that form tested with such two entities. Thereafter, there is a fees for it. You will, let me give you example for enrollment in Delhi, state of Delhi. The cost of the form is about 1100 rupees. Cost of the form is about 1100 rupees, and the entire expenditure, which would be incurred in the process for enrollment, comes around 10,000 or 11,000. After getting attestation of the form and connecting the documents with it, you have to deposit the form to the state government. As I am giving you example for enrollment in Delhi, so you have to deposit that form in the Delhi Bar Council office, which is at 342. After depositing the form, you will get a date of interview or interaction from the office of Delhi Bar Council. You have to appear on the date informed to you or to the candidate. Thereafter, interaction with you. A meeting is fixed between the members of the Bar Council of Delhi. In that meeting, the enrollment number will be allocated to each of the candidates. Here is the procedure, it is the only procedure for enrollment. After getting the enrollment number, you have to apply for the ID card for Bar Council of Delhi. Thereafter, after giving the form to the candidate, I card from Bar Council of India, the Bar Council of Delhi will be issued to you, and within the span of 30 days, Bar Council of Delhi will also issue a certificate. Each of the candidates will get a message on it on their mobile number as to when and where they have to collect the certificate, enrollment certificate. This is the only
And the next question is regarding the failure in the examination. What will happen with God forbid the student has written, if I will not be able to clear this exam at first take, then what is the further procedure? Is my enrollment with the state got cancelled with that?
No. The student or the candidate will remain enrolled as an provisional entity. The enrollment will not get cancelled in that case. But as I have already informed you, the approach before the introduction of All India Bar Examination is a bit literal. Therefore, the Bar Council of India allows a candidate to appear repeatedly till the time he or she clears the exam. So it is not like this that either the enrollment will get cancelled or there is a bar that a candidate cannot appear more than 2 or 3 times. It is not like that. It is completely in favor of the candidate and in the well-wishing of the candidate. He can appear, he or she can appear twice, thrice, four, fifth time, till the time he clears the pass already or the enrollment will not get cancelled, but the candidate will remain only as a professional advocate.
Okay. Sir, one more student has a question that can a person become part of two state bar councils at one time?
If any of the candidates has enrolled himself or herself supposedly with Delhi Bar Council, it means Delhi Bar Council will be the parent authority for that candidate to provide license. And if in case there is a undertaking mentioned in the form for enrollment only that you have you ever applied for enrollment with any other bar council, so there is an undertaking. If you get yourself enrolled in another or in the second bar council, you will be considered as a fraud. And the proceedings against that candidate shall be initiated by respective bar council. So, none of the candidates can apply or can obtain or can apply for the enrollment in two bar council.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you everyone for joining us. Thank you so much, sir. A recorded version of this webinar will be available at our YouTube channel of Bhutarakan International Business School. Thank you so much everyone for joining.